Okay, hello guys, welcome to this new video where we are going to learn new words in English. Especially the idea is increase your vocabulary and you have different ways to say a different thing. The first word is stay away. Have you heard about stay away? So this is a phrasal verb. Let's see the meaning on the dictionary. So as you can see, stay away is a phrasal verb. Stay away from somebody or something. That means that to not go near a particular person or place. I want you to stay away from my daughter. I just couldn't stay away. Let's see some examples in an image, in some images, so that it can be better. It can be easily to remember the example of stay away, right? The first example that we have is this little this little cat that is taking possession of the computer, right? She doesn't, or the cat doesn't want you to be near of the computer. So the cat says, stay away from my computer. Stay away from the computer. The next example, normally when we are a more adult, or when we are adults, we can give the advice to children that they stay away from strangers. Don't be near of them because they can be dangerous people, right? So you give the advice to children that they stay away from strangers, okay? So stay away from a stranger. Now, the next example here that we have is an apple a day keeps the doctor away. So we have here a lady that is throwing an apple and she say, stay away from my family. And the doctor says, oh no, an apple, my only weakness. So here we are saying in a form of joke that you need to stay healthy by eating something healthy like an apple a day. It will maintain you stay away, or it will stay away from the doctor because you are not sick and you are not going to stay there. So now let's start with the second word, that is hazy. Hazy. Have you heard about hazy? So the word is this one, hazy. This is an adjective. And as you can see, we have also comparative, hazier, and superlative, haziest. What is the meaning of hazy? Not clear because of haze. Hazy afternoon or sky, hazy light sunshine. The mountains were hazy in the distance. The room was hazy with the smoke. Today is October 16, and the previous weeks, the previous months in Vancouver, Greater Vancouver, that is all the small cities like Burnaby, Vancouver, Surrey, Langley, Delta, and all these cities, they all of them conform Greater Vancouver. And in Greater Vancouver, we receive a lot of smoke because of the wildfires. Do you know what is a wildfire? So, wildfire, let me show you what is a wildfire. This is wildfire. So we have wildfire that we have here is a noun, and it's a very big fire that spreads quickly and burns natural areas like woods, forest, and grassland. So how do the wildfires looks like? So as you can see, we have a multiple burning on the trees. So that is very horrible because they generate smoke. And you can see with those burnings or those wildfires that we have in Vancouver a similar situation like this. The sky was not clear, and that's the meaning of hazy. We have a hazy day. We have hazy days. All the buildings and all the mountains, we were having hazy days, and it was because of the wildfires. Those wildfires, they were created, or they started in United States, especially over this zone. So all the smoke were propagating to the north, and it arrived to Greater Vancouver, as I was saying. So that is hazy. We had hazy days on the previous weeks. Hazy days. That means not clear scenarios, not clear days. Hazy day. Another way that we can say the word hazy is by not having, not clear because of lack of memory, understanding or detail. A hazy memory idea. The dividing line is somewhat hazy. What happened next is all very hazy. I have only a very hazy idea about how the economy works. So when you are saying that you have a hazy idea, is that you are a little bit confused about something that you have learned or some instructions that somebody have given you. Now, for example, let's see that in image. So basically that you have hazy ideas or hazy understanding is that you have not clear. So you are not clear about what to do next. Your mind is in struggles because you are confused. You don't have clearly a scenario about what it needs to be done. A hazy idea. I'm a little bit hazy about how to start to immigrate to Canada. I'm a little bit hazy about the class that I received today from mathematics. So hazy, not clear about something. Okay, so the next word is hazardous. Have you heard about hazardous? When something is hazardous, if you are driving, something can be hazardous. If you are not paying attention, something could be hazardous. What could be hazardous while you drive or while you are on the street? So let's see the example of the meaning of hazardous. This is an adjective, hazardous, this is the pronunciation, and it says involving risk or danger, especially to somebody's health or safety. Hazardous waste, material, substance, and chemicals. They endure a hazardous journey through thickening fog. It would be hazardous to invest so much. Hazardous to something, to somebody. A list of products that are potentially hazardous. Health. So even the word is very simple. It's dangerous. That could be the synonym. Let's see some examples that can be very helpful to remember the word. You know, sometimes when we see the word only in theory, but we try to see some images or some examples, it would be much, much better to remember the word. So hazardous, as we can notice, is something dangerous, right? So we have different examples of hazardous symbols or hazardous materials, icons. This could be hazardous, right? These are the examples of hazardous areas. Now, what about when you are driving? We can have reckless drivers and those type of users that they don't pay attention. These reckless drivers, they are very hazardous when you drive because it can create some accidents and people can be hurt or even they can be dead or suffer an injury, right? Another thing that we can have when we are driving is potholes or cracks. Oh God, if you are driving and you notice this kind of potholes or cracks on the street, they are not so good for your wheels on your while you are driving, because they can also be hazardous ways, hazardous for all the interaction that we have while we are driving. Another thing that it can be hazardous while you are driving or when you have here is wet or oily roads. So when you have oily roads or wet roads, it can generate also accidents while you are driving. So it could be easily that you can slip while you are driving and you can easily lose the control of the car. Or for example, another example of hazardous, it could be animal crossing. So while you are driving, if you suddenly see some animals crossing, it could be also very hazardous action that you are not going to take control, could generate some accidents, right? And the last example of hazardous is, for example, when we have construction zones. right? So we have construction areas. This could be also hazardous places, because sometimes the workers are taking some space where the cars should be passing through, and it could be hazardous. You need to be very careful with workers, and they also give you the signs of stops or something to be very careful. So that's the word hazardous. What's hazardous for you? The next example is to have a bunch. So what's the meaning of bunch? Okay, so bunch, what we are going to see is that bunch is a noun, bunch. And it says that it's a number of things of the same type which are growing or fastened together. A bunch of bananas, grapes, etc. A bunch of keys. She picked me a bunch of flowers. She put all the flowers together in a big bunch. So having a bunch, as you can see, we can have a bunch of bananas. I have a bunch of bananas. We went to the supermarket to buy a bunch of bananas, right? We also have a bunch of keys. I cannot imagine. You cannot imagine how many keys I have nowadays. I have a bunch of keys. Now, also you can have a bunch of video games. You have a lot of games on your, in your bedroom, in your house, on your, in your great. You went to buy a bunch of video games on the store. So basically, also we can have a different bunch of things, like the fruit, cherries, apple, peach, kiwi fruit, watermelon, persimmon, pomegranate, lychee, bunch of grapes, fig, avocados, apricot, dates, pears, plum, and rhubarb. So I have a bunch of words that I am learning today with you guys. Okay, and the final word or sentence that we are going to learn today is to catch up. Have you heard about catch up? Catch up is a phrasal verb. Normally you say catch up when you want to reach somebody that is faster than you, or that when the other person has a better knowledge or it has a better performance than the person has, right? So as we can see, the definition is a catch up is phrasal verb, to reach somebody who is ahead by going faster. Go on ahead, I'll catch you up. And the second meaning is to reach the same level of standard of somebody, right? So now let's see the examples. For example, you can catch up somebody that is in front of you because they are moving faster than you. So for example, this person can say, I'll catch you up, right? So he's going to reach the other person. And the other thing, for example, if you are on a marathon, the person is going to say, hey, I'll catch you up, buddy. So he's going to try to reach the person because the other person or the other thing is in front of it, right? And the next example that we can see is, for example, try to study harder to catch your classmates up. So for example, how to catch up your studies. Right, how to catch up your studies on if you have fallen behind, if you are behind the other ones. So normally when we are catching up or catching my or mates up, is that you need to study harder because they are in a more level advanced than the currently you are. Okay, so I hope that you really like these words. And that is going to be everything. I hope that you really like it, and see you the next time, buddies.